Hey guys and welcome back. Today we are going to create this fading carousel using HTML and Bootstrap, and I have created some of the starter files which you can download from the description below. Click on the link and download the folder. It contains these images that we are using in the carousel, and I have already created the basic HTML file with the necessary links to the Bootstrap CDN as well as the jQuery. So the document is pretty much ready for us to just get in and create the carousel. So get inside the body tag and create a div, and let's write the class as container-fluid. And this container-fluid is a responsive class of Bootstrap, and it takes the entire width of the screen. Then get inside and create another div, and let's write the class as carousel space slide space carousel-fade, and ID as my-carousel. The data-ride attribute and the value as carousel. Carousel class defines a basic carousel, and carousel-fade class is responsible for getting the fading in and fading out of the slides. Drop down below and let's start with the carousel indicators, and these are the indicators which represent or indicate which slide of the carousel is active. Then create a OL tag. OL tag is the ordered list tag, and class as carousel-indicators. Alright, then get below and create a LI tag, that is the list tag, and data target attribute as #my-carousel. Then data-slide-2, 0. Then copy this entire li tag and paste it twice and change 0 to 1 and then 2, and let's make the middle one as the active one by adding class active. Alright, then get below and let's define the rest of the carousel. Create a div tag and let's write the class as carousel-inner, and then let's define the slides one by one. Create a div tag and write class as carousel-item space text-center space active, and let's give it a background color. So create a style tag and background color as teal. Alright, then get inside and create another div tag, and then create a image tag, that is the img tag inside it, and the source as img://profile-1.jpg. Class as w-100, and this w-100 is one of the utility or the helper classes of the Bootstrap 4, which are used to quickly style elements without using any CSS code, and w-100 represents 100% of the width. Alright, then rounded-circle. This class creates a rounded image, and this rounded-circle is one of the Bootstrap 4 image shapes. Let's write the class img-box in div, and we will define this class later in the CSS space border. This will create a border around the circle. Then rounded-circle स्पेस एम हाइफेन ऑटो. एम हाइफेन ऑटो इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द यूटिलिटी और द हेल्पर क्लासेस ऑफ द बूटस्ट्रैप 4, एंड दिस इज फॉर गेटिंग मार्जिन ऑटो. Anyways, then get outside the div tag and create a heading tag that is h5 tag and write class as py-1. Py-1 is also one of the utility or the helper classes of Bootstrap 4. This is to get padding of 1 rem top and bottom, and similarly my-1 is to get 1 rem of margin top and bottom. Then get inside and create a strong tag. This is for getting bold text. Then write class as text-warning. This text-warning has a special color attributed to it. And let's write any text. And you can see the color of this text-warning class. Then get down and create another heading tag, h6 tag, and write class as m-1. This will get 1 rem of margin all around it. Space text-light. We will use this class to get light colored font. Then write first slide. Then create a p tag and let's write the class as py-3. This is to get 3 rem of padding top and bottom. Then text-white. Then let me paste the text. Alright. So this has created one slide in the carousel. Now all we can do is just copy this entire div tag and paste it twice to create two more slides. All right. And we need to remove this active class from the rest of the two slides because we cannot have more than one slide as active. And just edit the text and the name of the images or the source of the images. Alright, so I'm keeping the middle one as the active one. Alright. The carousel is active and it is working as it should. And we just need to add few more things like the next and the previous buttons. So get outside these div tags. And this is here where the carousel inner is ending. And now let's define the carousel controls. So create a link, that is the A tag, and the link as #my-carousel because that is the ID of the carousel, and then class as carousel-control-next and role attribute as button, then data-slide as prev. Then create a span tag and write class as carousel-control-prev-icon. This will get the previous or the prev icon. Create another span tag and write class as sr-only and the text as previous. Then copy this entire link, paste it And let's just change the name since this is going to be the next button. Alright, so I have misspelled the first one. It has to be prev. So that has created the previous button completely. And this second one has to be the next button. So change all the previews to next and this previous to next. Alright. So we have the control buttons as well. And the indicators are working as well. So with this we have completed the HTML part. And now let's get into the CSS. Let's reference the container-fluid class first and write margin as 0 and padding as 0. Alright, then .carousel-item and padding as 100 pixels. Then carousel-item space .img-box. This is the class that we have used with the images to make them smaller. Width as 135 pixels and height as 135 pixels. And looks pretty neat and clean. Now let's position the indicators better. Alright. And if you remove this carousel-fade class from the main div tag containing the carousel, this becomes a normal carousel with the slides are sliding in and sliding out. So with this we have completed the fading in and fading out carousel. If you like the video, please hit like button and subscribe to the channel. And if there is any topic that you want me to make videos on, you can let me know down in the comment section. Anyways, I'm going to see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.